Yo, what's good, y'all? We back once again with another video. And in this video, we're going to be talking about the NBA championship contending team that no one seems to be talking about this season. And you know, this team does got a couple what ifs or a couple like, you know, wait and see type of the situation going on. But I'm going to say that I got a little more faith in this team than I do in the other team I talked about last video, which was the Brooklyn Nets. And the team I'm talking about in this video is the Los Angeles Clippers. The LA Clippers have basically been a well-oiled machine all season. And that's been without their best players, Kawhi Leonard, who's been out all season, you know, still rehabbing from that ACL tear that happened back in June. And Paul George, who played a few games, but he's basically been out the whole season. And right now, during the making of this video, they stand as the 8th seed in the Western Conference with a record of 34-33. And they're better than the rival Lakers, which is kind of crazy to think about considering the circumstances of the Clippers' injury luck this season. And, you know, the Lakers making splashes during the offseason. But the Clippers have been, they've been balling. For a team dealing with what they've been dealing with, they've been balling. They've been led by Reggie Jackson, which is kind of crazy. He's been playing well. He's been playing the best basketball of his career, I'd say. And they also have a coach of the year candidate in Tyronn Lue. And I predicted he would be in the race before the season started, as he's proven ever since last postseason that he is one of the elite coaches in the NBA. He's not the guy that just, you know, coached LeBron and LeBron carried him all the way to the finals. No, he's actually an elite basketball mind. You know, I was one of those people that criticized him too. I didn't think he was that good of a coach. But when you look at what he's been doing with this Clippers team for ever since that moment, like I said, ever since the postseason last year, he's a really good coach. One of the top, I'd say even top five coaches in the NBA right now. Now, you may be asking, why do you think the Clippers have a shot at the title when their two best players aren't even on the floor? But that's the thing. Those two guys are almost on track to return before the season's over. And heading into the playoffs, this team could be extremely dangerous because right now, they're an above-average team, and they're just full of a whole bunch of really good role players, like Reggie Jackson, Luke Kennard, Marcus Morris, Zubac. They're all good players. They're not stars. They're missing those two guys, but, you know, they are really good role players. Then you add into the fact that during the trade deadline, they went and added Norman Powell, who's a guy that can average 15 for a season. We know he can do that. Robert Covington, who's one of the league's best 3-and-D players, and he's been one of the best 3-and-D players for a few years now. So they got good players on this team without Kawhi and Paul George. Now adding them into the mix, we're talking about a potential championship team. But let's also talk about how basically this is the same roster from last season. And if you guys remember, this team was in the Western Conference Finals last year. And they lost to the Phoenix Suns in 6 games. But the thing was, Kawhi didn't even play now 1 minute in that series. I'm going to go out and say this, that if Kawhi plays in that series and he's healthy with Paul George and the way Reggie Jackson was playing during that series too, the Clippers beat the Suns. And to be honest, the Bucks, even though they won the title, they were a shaky team. So I would have picked the Clippers to win the title that year if Kawhi was healthy. So now let's look at this season, where I'd argue they got a slightly more talented roster from last season when healthy, and they might go into the playoffs with a healthy Paul George and Kawhi, because Kawhi, we saw him working out versus the Warriors before the game. They said they got no limits on him. They're just trying to ease him back in. He might return before the season's over. Paul George, they're talking about he might return before the season's over. Now, I get they might have to ease their way, you know, into the game for a little, especially Kawhi, who hasn't played since June. But if these guys come back before the play-in tournament starts and they have some games to get underneath their belt, get a little, you know, flow, then they would be going into the play-in or the playoffs, wherever they're at, with one of the best rosters in basketball, in my opinion. And they're a top four team on paper in the Western Conference. I'm going to say that, a top four team. Who's better than them besides Phoenix, Golden State on paper? And to be honest, you can make the argument that the Clippers probably have the second best roster on paper in the West behind the Suns. I don't know. I'm not a Utah Jazz guy, so I think they're better than the Jazz. I don't even think they're that far from the Jazz right now without Kawhi and Paul George. No disrespect, but I'm just not a big Jazz guy. But, you know, when you look at this team, they're already one of the top 10 best defensive teams in basketball. But adding Kawhi and Paul George, obviously that's going to boost that, because those two guys are some of the best, or probably two of the top five best two-way players in the NBA. I don't think you can argue that. Also, adding them into the mix would give them a major shot in the arm on the offensive end, because they rank 26th in points per game, 26th in offensive rating. And we know, I get that, because at times when you watch the Clippers play, Reggie Jackson is the number one option. And sometimes Reggie Jackson can be an inefficient shot chucker. And the offense could also have no flow at times. But that's mainly because of the lack of a go-to guy, a true number one option in the lineup. That's a guaranteed 25 to 30 points. But if you add those two back in the mix, that easily gets solved. Easily. They would, in my opinion, be a major threat to the Suns, Warriors, Grizzlies in the series. Easily. And they could find their way back into a chase for a finals appearance if all goes well. If the Clippers decide not to bring Leonard back this season, then you could pretty much guarantee that this Clippers team is a surefire contender in the Western Conference next season, and in the league, to be honest. But the only question is, will health get in the way? And how many years are the Clippers going to keep making a run at this? Because remember, they did trade a lot of draft capital, and they traded a young rising star at the time in Shai Gilgeous-Alexander to bring in Paul George to help Kawhi and get that ring. But it's been 2.5 years. Time's going by fast, and more teams are getting better. You know, look at the Memphis Grizzlies, for example, who are probably the best young team in basketball and took a leap, a major leap, all the way into the top two right now in the Western Conference. Look at them. You know, so time's ticking. The Clippers got time. They got more time than the Lakers do, because LeBron James is old. He's still a great player, but he's old. Anthony Davis is injury prone, so the Clippers got more time than them. But do the Clippers got more time than, you know, I mean, the Denver Nuggets are still young. The Grizzlies are getting better. The Mavericks, I think they still need a couple more extra pieces, but Luka is still mad young. So they can make a run at it one day. So we gotta see with that. But I'm gonna go out and say that the Clippers are a potential title contender this season. If Kawhi and Paul George come back, watch out for this team. That's all I gotta say, because right now they're playing some pretty solid basketball. I mean, I get they've lost two in a row, but before that they were on a 5-game winning streak. Reggie Jackson was red hot, and they do have a game against the Wizards before they're making it this video. So, or when this video drops, they've played a game against the Wizards. We'll see what happens there. But right now, who can argue that this Clippers team really shouldn't even be in the position that they're in, but they're still there. And that's without two of the top at least 15 basketball players in the world. Kawhi, top five, and Paul George are on that 10 to 15 range. But anyways, that's going to do it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Link will be down in the description below. This has been The Checkup, where we talk hoops and hoops only. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.